Hello and welcome to a brand new BFD3 tutorial. In this video, I'm going to be looking at the slightly more advanced topic of drum bleed or spill and tom resonance. Now, drum bleed is something that we had in BFD2, it's also here in BFD3, and tom resonance is brand new to BFD3. They're somewhat related, so I'm going to cover them together in this video. So what is drum bleed? Well, drum bleed is the phenomenon where when you're recording an acoustic drum kit and you have many microphones around it, if you hit a particular drum, let's say a snare drum, that snare drum will be picked up not only by the snare mic, but also by other mics around it. Tom resonance is a different phenomenon. When a drummer hits, for example, a snare drum, some of the other drums around it will resonate in sympathy. That is to say that the vibrations in the air caused by the drummer hitting the snare drum will cause other drums to vibrate as well. And this is most noticeable in the toms. So, BFD3 has features for managing these phenomena. First of all, let's take a listen to what these sound like. I've got two identical presets here. One with all the bleeds and tom resonance turned off, and one with them all turned on. First of all, here's the preset without. Okay, now I'll load up the other preset. Now this one, remember, has all the mic bleed features and the tom resonance features enabled. So hopefully what you can detect here, and it is subtle, but what you can detect is that the second preset has a slightly more kind of weighty bottom end, and that is or the various signals bleeding into different microphones, and also the tom resonances causing a kind of a low frequency that just helps to glue the sound together a little bit more. And it's entirely personal preference whether or not you use these at all. So first of all, let's look at mic bleed. In the tech panel here, there is a section here for bleed. The BFD3 library only contains bleed in the kick and snare drum microphones. And the reason for that is if we recorded the bleed signal for every single microphone, then the data on your hard drive, the amount of samples, would go up exponentially. You'd have an enormous sample set. And we didn't feel that that was worth it. So what you've got is the kick and the snare, which are often the most prominently used ones when mixing down a drum kit. These ones have got bleed enabled. And in the bleed section, what you'll see whenever you select any drum in your mixer, you'll see the kick and snare bleed controls here. And these can be individually enabled. So I've got the mid-tom selected here. And in the mid-tom, I can decide whether to have the kick bleed, i.e. the sound of the tom going through the kick microphones, or the snare microphones enabled. Currently, these are both on. Now you're also seeing signals in the floor and high tom channels, and this is from the tom resonance and tom spill synthesized elements, which I'll come to in a minute, but for now we'll keep looking at just the kick and snare bleed. There are three options here. If I turn them off, you'll see that there's no signal in the kick or snare channel. Now the third option here is the direct option. What this does is something that actually isn't possible in the real recording of an acoustic drum kit. That sends the bleed signal back to the main channel. So in this case, it would actually mix the bleed signal from the mid-tom back into the mid-tom direct channel. You'll notice you can't see it there in the kick or snare channel, but it is being mixed back into the mid tom channel. This just gives you more options when mixing. If you're using heavy compression or something, you can make sure that you're absolutely compressing all those juicy tom signals together. The trim controls to the left-hand side control volume levels for the bleed signal going to the kick or snare. So if I pull the kick one right down, you'll see there's no kick signal. Up again, we have our kick bleed. Finally, in this section, you've got the global send and return controls. The send control is a global trim for all bleed and tom resonance signals. So, for example, if I want to stop this mid-tom from causing any bleed or resonance in any other channel, then I can pull this right down. When I hit my mid-tom, you'll see that there are no signals caused in any other channels. By contrast, the return control is a global trim for all the signals coming in to the mid-tom channel. So if I pull this down, you'll see that the mid-tom channel is not generating any bleed or tom resonance signals because that global return trim is pulled right down. So let's look at the tom resonance. This is found in the model page. And the reason bleed and tom resonance are found in different panels, this tech and model distinction that you see here, is that bleed signals are actually samples. So when we recorded all these drums, the bleed signals from the kick and snare microphones were actually recorded, and that's what you're hearing when you enable the bleed here in the tech panel. The model page, however, is algorithmically generated tom resonance. That is to say, it's not a real recording, it's a virtual emulation. So for every drum you have loaded in the mixer, you'll see a tom resonance panel, and you can enable these per drum. Once enabled, for example, on my kick drum, the tom resonance feature will cause the toms to resonate in sympathy when the kick is hit. If I turn up the resonance trim, you'll hear that sympathetic resonance much louder across the three toms. If I turn it down, the spill trim control adjusts the volume of the spill emulation for the toms. Now, spill is just another word for bleed. So what this does is emulate the sound of the kick drum coming through the tom microphones. If I turn that up and turn the resonance down and hit my kick, you can hear the sound of the kick drum coming through the tom microphones. So that's it for bleed and tom resonance. Join me for another BFD3 tutorial soon. Thank you.